Kansas Shrine Bowl has showcased the top high school senior football players from across the state of Kansas. But the Kansas Shrine Bowl is much more than a game. This select fraternity of All-Stars has helped the Kansas Shrine Bowl donate more than $3.8 million to Shriners Children's Hospitals while playing for the kids. Tonight, we have Shriners from the Mirza Temple and a Shriners Children's Patient Ambassadors here to extend an official invitation to Chanute High School senior Augustus Thuston. Invited Augustus to play or participate in the 51st annual Kansas Shrine Bowl presented by Mammoth. This selection was the result of media voting and coach selections following the 2023 football season. The 24 Kansas Shrine Bowl will take place Saturday, June 29th at 7 p.m. in Emporia. All net proceeds from the Kansas Shrine Bowl benefit Shriners Children's, where they provide the most amazing care anywhere and are dedicated to improving the lives of children by providing pediatric specialty care, innovative research, and outstanding teaching programs for medical professionals. Children up to the age of 18 are eligible for care and receive all services in a family-centered environment, regardless of the patient's ability to pay. Additional events include the Kansas Masonic All-Star Marching Band Camp, the Kansas Shrine Bowl All-Star Cheer Camp, the All-Star Friday Night Showcase, Golf Tournament Parade, and much more. To show your support for our Kansas Shrine Bowl All-Star visit, visit www.kansasshrinebowl.com/support. Thank you, Shriners, and congratulations to Blue Comet senior Augustus Thuston, 2024 Kansas Shrine Bowl East All-Star. Take this opportunity to go to the concession stand to support the boys' golf team. And be sure to buy your Hoops for Cash tickets for halftime of the boys' game and have a chance to win $130 from You Got It Home Savings Bank. winners will meet Mr. Chris Bilby and an administrator at the Southwest door of the gym. After halftime performances are finished, the two winners will compete in this shooting contest. They will have 30 seconds to make a layup for $5, free throw for $10, and a 3-point for $15. Then they have a chance to make the layup before they can shoot a free throw, etc. Then both contestants have had their 30 seconds. They will both get one attempt at a halftime half-court shot worth $100. This is brought to you courtesy of Home Savings Bank. see those guys back on Chanute turf again. Now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, won't you please stand and remove your hats and face the flag as we honor the United States of America with the playing of our national anthem by the Chanute High School Band under the direction of Mrs. Rebecca Davis.
Hello and welcome to an SEK men's basketball matchup between the Chanute Blue Comets and the Fort Scott Tigers. We have an exciting game ahead of us. Both of these teams are in contention of the playoffs, and this can alter the seeding of the playoffs depending on who wins. This stream is brought to you by our Comet Vision crew here at CHS. I'm Bryson Ginswider along with Braylon Rita, and we're just about ready for tip-off. It's going to be an exciting game. We're coming off a huge win. Our starters are senior Jordan Duncan, who had 23 points in the last game. Senior Caden Seamster, senior Rhett Smith, senior Larson Kester, and junior Elliot Stevenson. In our last game, we scored 29 points in that fourth quarter. Huge to end up winning that game. Tonight, we need to keep that on a roll. And the starters for the Fort Scott Tigers, they have junior J.D. Troutman, junior Caden Cohey, junior Jace Curley, junior Micah Sanders, junior Isaac Hall. They are all juniors. They only have two seniors on their entire team. This is going to be a great game. We need Chanute to keep their momentum alive. What are you thinking for tonight, Braylon?
I'm thinking tonight we got a really good game on our hands right here, Bryson. Like you said, Jordan Duncan coming off a 23-point game. Also, as you said, Chanute scoring 29 points in the fourth quarter. Jordan Duncan is not somebody that you want to see, want to leave open behind the three-point. We got us a good matchup right here. It's looking like a pretty good game.
And I have a feeling tonight that Jordan Duncan will not get many shots off. Fort Scott had to see the film of him hitting those, I believe it was 7 3-pointers, a career high for him. I think it was 6 3-pointers. But I don't think that he will get very many open looks. I believe he'll be face guarded and will basically be playing 4-on-4 out there on offense. We got a heck of a game coming up. Everyone stay tuned. We have an amazing student section out here ready to rock and roll. Tip-off is right around the corner. Oh, I'm excited, Braylon.
I'm excited too, Bryson. Now, we always talk about this before games. Fort Scott looking to have the height advantage as mm-hmm. they have number 24, Rocco. He is 6'6".
Yeah, and they also have Moreland, who is 6'3", Anderson, who's 6'2". Here comes tip-off, ladies and gentlemen. And this game is underway. Looks like Fort Scott ends up winning the tip. Ball is now in the hands.
There's two.
All right. Ball is there swinging it around, looking to find someone. Top of the key, fakes the shot, tries to get to his spot. Drives baseline, swings it around. Number five almost shoots it. Great ball movement on this possession. And they're just going to reset it. They're just going to reset it, run it back up. Great ball movement and great defense playing at the same time here.
This right here is the perks of having no shot clock. You can run a play, and then if that play don't work, easily just switch into another play.
Mm-hmm. Big 6'6 center. It's good to have Caden Seamster on him, our most athletic player. And I think our tallest as well. Derek sizes up the shot, does not take it. He goes up and misses. Rebound is everywhere. No one, it ends up in the hands of Larson. And they're going to slow it down, try to get something to work here.
Real tough shot right there. Caden Seamster's hand was all up in his face right there. Still went up with the shot. Ball bounced around. Came back to Larson.
Elliot Stevenson with the ball. Does it behind the back. Gets to the bucket. It is missed, but Rhett Smith is there to get the putback layup. That is the first 2 points of the night, as exciting as they can be on a putback layup like that.
Great, great cut in by Rhett right there. Seeing that the ball was not going in, came up, put back Boss.
Dirks with the ball. He's a lot smaller than Seamster, but possibly an advantage in the speed department. They almost get the ball in to their 6'6 big man, Rocco, but they do not get it. It is tipped away, but it gets back in the hands of Fort Scott. Mid-range pull-up. That is Cash. Number five, Cal Cosins with the mid-range.
Great move right there, sizing up the defender, cutting right on into the mid-range, pulling the jump shot.
I believe that Larson's lip is bleeding. They're just making sure he is all right. Going to be Chanute ball still. That was an official timeout. It's not counted against Chanute here.
On the windup when they win. Fort Scott poked that ball free. Number 24, Oroko. Hand came up, hit Lars right in the mouth.
Elliot has been very aggressive in this first quarter. Rhett Smith at the top of the key, looking around, finds that man, Jordan Duncan. Larson makes a move. See, Jordan is just being blanketed. Look how far, he's pretty deep out there, and he is still being face guarded.
They know that you do not want to leave him open.
Mm-hmm. Larson had a possible driving opportunity. Kicks it to Seamster in the corner. It is up, and it is off the rim. Almost recovered by Chanute, but it is back in the hands. And that ball is thrown off of Jordan's knees. As now it is going to be Fort Scott ball. Both teams playing very fast defense. Closing out on everything very quick.
Very aggressive, too.
Closing up passing lanes. They know that this game is big. I mean, this, you can kind of feel kind of a playoff atmosphere in here. In the corner. Almost tries to make a play. Dirks ended up running to the corner. A little miscommunication there. Ball is thrown out of bounds. That is a turnover for Fort Scott. It is now Chanute's ball.
Both teams having three losses right now. I believe Fort Scott is 12-3, and Chanute right now is 11-3. Let's hope Chanute can come off this win, make it 12-4.
There's that man. Jordan Duncan misses the three. First shot of the night. We'll see him hopefully get some more looks tonight.
Now in the Iola game, Jordan Duncan in the first half did not start off too well. He came in clutch that fourth quarter. Iola was up double digits, I believe. And him sparking up the threes really put a momentum in the Chanute offense. So let's hope that can happen tonight.
Looks like they're trying to get Dub Chipman to make a play. Great help defense by Rhett, and he's hustling for that ball. And that is a jump ball, and that is going to be Chanute's ball. Great play from Rhett Smith there to poke the ball away and then dive on it to force a turnover.
Great double team right there. He could not go left or right. Made a mistake. Rhett poking that ball free, diving for the ball, coming up with the jump ball, Chanute ball right here.
It's not always about the points that you score. It's about how you play on the court, how much heart you leave out there, your ability to dive on those loose balls. Elliott makes a little spin move, misses the layup off the right side of the rim. Ball moving up the court. Dirks is on, sizing up Elliott. Dub with the ball, moves it around. Number five makes a play. That's into Dirks' hands. Gets it back to number five. Another closeout. Great defense by Chanute right now. Closing out on everything, not allowing a shot. Screen by Rocco. They switch perfectly.
This is the defense you want to see from Chanute, especially when they have somebody that is 6'6 down in that paint.
On the outside, Rhett gets up, and it is knocked down by Cal Cosins. He has all
There's three.
He has all 5 points on the night for for Scott.
It's great defense right there by Chanute, but one guy slipped away, causes them to get the 3-point.
And Rhett still got a pretty great contest on that. It's just Larson in the corner opts out of the three. Now Rhett in the corner, he doesn't take the three. He goes right at 6'6", big man. He says, I don't care how tall you are, I'm going to go at you all night. There's a push called on Rocco. And we have Dub Chipman is checking it out for Kanan Brown, 6'3 sophomore. Looking to find somebody, gets it into Elliott. Elliott throws a kind of a wild little pass, but Larson gets it, gets into the paint. There is not a foul called somehow. I mean, I don't know what the refs are seeing, but great play by Rhett Smith again, forcing a turnover. We just need to have a shot fall down. Seamster going to the bucket, knocks it down. For a second there, I thought he was about to slam that on his head. That would have got the crowd going.
Great look to Caden. Caden finding that open lane, cut down, easy lay.
Another steal from Rhett Smith. He's going to the hoop. He lays it up, it's up and good. Rhett is playing phenomenal so far.
Great read, reading the guard, following where his eyes are going. Rhett knew he was going to the other guard. Mm-hmm. Rhett came up, stole the ball.
Dirks doesn't shoot it. They're trying to find something. Dirks with a tough layup right there.
Rhett all up in his face right there. Dirks hit
Elliott
it.
And one.
Dirks hit it with the swoop. And one. Elliott's going to the free throw.
You love to see that. Aggressive Elliott is a scary sight to see if you were on the other team. And he is a very efficient free throw shooter. We're looking for him to knock those down. Rhett Smith is checking out. He's getting sort of an ovation here because he's played so great. Bilby has now checked in for Rhett Smith. Elliott shoots the free throw, knocks it down.
Both teams exchanging points right now. This is the type of game we like to see right here.
Something big that we've seen from Chanute so far is no turnovers. And they forced four on the other side. Trying to get it. Bilby is now on a pretty rough mismatch. There's a blocking foul called on Larson. I don't know if you heard it, Braylon, but nobody in the gym agreed with that. But we're the home team. We're not going to agree with anything. Larson checking out for Chris Harding. That is the sophomore. Quaddy with the ball. Moreland with the ball. Dirks now has it. Looking around. Elliott has been on Dirks all night. I'm pretty sure that's a big matchup. Elliott is one of our best defenders. Jordan almost takes the charge, but it is bounced out, and Seamster grabs the rebound. Moving up the court now. Seamster with the ball. Gets it to Jordan. Elliott finds Chris. There's Jordan deep. I mean, sometimes he'll let those things fly, I'll tell you that. Bilby with the ball. Great one-handed pass down into Chris, but ball's just being moved around. We want to find our shot. We don't want them to force us into a shot. 51 seconds left. We can honestly take this whole into this quarter if we want to. Gets the ball down into Seamster. Goes up. Gets the bucket. I thought that was about to be an and one, but no foul is called there.
Great pass right there from Jordan. Finding that Caden was on the backside of the defender. Great pass. Took a tough layup right there.
Air ball is the free throw. Not something you like to see. Elliott with the ball, top of the key. Gets it to Jordan, he's wide open. He shoots that. It is good. Jordan Duncan. Nothing gets me excited like Jordan hitting the three.
We've talked about this all night, ladies and gentlemen. You do not want to leave Jordan Duncan open behind that three.
There's a missed shot and a push in the back on Rocco. It is Chanute ball with, I believe that's 1.3 seconds. Can't tell if that's one point. I think it's 1.3 seconds left. So I'm not sure what we're going to run here with 1 second. I mean, just Jordan's down there somewhere, maybe. We might just run that. Jalen is actually checking in for Jordan. That is his brother checking in for him.
The freshman.
The freshman, indeed he is. And he plays great defense. Travel is called. I think he just didn't get the shot off. That's the end of this first quarter. We are going to, I think we're going to take a break with you. We'll be back at the end. We'll be back at the end of this little break. We'll be back.
Chanute does not consider community involvement a sales gimmick or a public relations ploy. They see it as a way to be a good neighbor.
We are back for this second quarter. Chanute Blue Comets out to a lead early, 14-7. Braylon, what have you seen so far that has impressed you from both sides?
The defense. Both teams playing crazy defense right now, but the Chanute passing the ball, Chanute finding the shots that they want. Like they found Jordan right there behind the arc. Those are the shots that they want to see right there.
Something that's really impressed me so far is that Chanute has zero turnovers. Oftentimes, Chanute turns the ball over often, but as you can see, when we don't turn the ball over, we get out the leads. We've also forced four turnovers, most of those because of Rhett Smith. He has been a dog out there, poking the ball free, diving on it, and I think we're in for an excellent game.
Both teams playing phenomenal ball right now. Chanute coming on top of that first quarter, 14-7.
Chanute's out here ready to play. Forscott now coming out. I believe it's going to be Forscott ball to start this. Second quarter. I mean, this game is so exciting. The first quarter is already done, and I feel like it just started a second ago. There's Moreland with the ball. Moving the ball around. Cal Cozens, who has most of the points here for Forscott. He's in the corner, possibly looking to find something. Moreland gets the ball. There's number 30. Does not opt to take the shot. He travels, but they don't call it.
Crowd wanting the three-second call in the lane right there. But.
And there's a push, I believe, on Bilby there. I mean, there's a couple calls that could have been called, but being an official is the hardest job in sports, so you don't want to give him too much blame, but. Ball's being moved around. Jalen Duncan gets it. He's going down the court. He lays it up. Great play by Jalen. Gets
read.
The steal.
Jalen jumping up. Pretty good vert right there.
He is an athletic
snagging
man.
Snagging that ball out of the air, taking it back.
I thought he was going to grab onto the rafters, I'll tell you that much.
I thought he was going to jump over the defender.
You can probably hear how active this student section and crowd is.
This is probably the loudest I've ever heard the student section right now.
This is a big game. Moreland gets to the paint, misses the layup. It's a 5-on-4 fast break. Chanute can move the ball up quick. They opt to just chill, relax, set up the offense, get the ball to Elliott. Jalen with that ball back in his hands. He's a very good passer. He is. Very good instincts when it comes to passing. Not a lot of turnovers are caused because of him.
Now, this is a very intense game right now. Both teams, Chanute and Fort Scott, are on top of the Southeast Kansas League right now.
Seamster makes a play, gets to the bucket. He has 6 points on the night. Chanute is going to take a timeout, Fort Scott's going to take a timeout. We're just going to stay here with you.
We have a great game on our hands right here, Bryson.
And that timeout was really forced by the play that Chanute is – by what Chanute is doing. That was an easy layup right at the rim. You don't want to see that as a coach.
Back to what I was saying, though, these two teams that we are watching right now are the top teams in the SEK League right now. This could be a preview of the SEK Championship.
It's Chanute Pittsburgh and Fort Scott. We're all tied, I believe, right now for the best record in SEK. This is a huge game regarding standings and home court advantage for the playoffs coming up soon.
And as you can see, Chanute and Fort Scott, Fort Scott's 1-0 up against Chanute right now. We went to Fort Scott, lost by 1 point, I believe. Chanute really showing that this home court advantage. Chanute really showing home court advantage right here.
And as a team, I believe it's pretty scary when you come out of your timeout and they're already lined up at the free throw line ready to defend you. Everybody on defense is playing extremely hard, not letting them get easy buckets, which is a fantastic thing to see. Dirks with the ball. They're playing a trap defense. There is Jalen Duncan getting very active with his hands. They're back. They're into a zone, like a 2-3 zone type. Trying not to allow any open shots. And, I mean, they haven't even really got past the three-point line yet.
Chanute really playing lockdown defense right now.
Cal with the ball, looking to find somebody. Gets trapped on the baseline. He goes out of bounds. That is Chanute ball. Forced a turnover. Landon Bilby forced that turnover by playing just straight up good defense. Rocco checks back in. That's that big 6'6 man. I mean, didn't know LeBron James is out there flopping. Chris Harding with the ball. Moving it around. In the hands of Jalen Duncan. Elliott with the ball. I'd like to see him stay aggressive like he was in that first quarter, I mean. Bilby with the big guy on him. You can see Seamster over there has a mismatch. He has Dirks on him, who tries to make a play on the ball. That's risky. Chris Harding in the corner. Makes a play into the paint. And there is a push-off called on Chris. And it is Fort Scott ball.
That is Chanute's first turnover of the night. Hopefully they don't let that get to their heads and we still stay on this hot pace that we've been on.
Something you'd like to see on that play is get the ball into Seamster when he was on that high post.
That mismatch right there.
He had that mismatch over Dirks, who's 5'11". That could have been a big play that ended in a bucket, but it did not. Cal with the ball, one of the few seniors on the team. He double dribbles. There's another turnover. Chanute is in their heads right now. And Cal gets checked off. Number 4, Caden Brown checks back in. It looks like Larson is checking in for Jalen. Jordan is checking in for Bilby. And Rhett is checking in for Seamster.
Now, Jordan and Jalen are brothers, but both of them are complete opposite.
Mm-hmm.
Jordan is amazing from behind the three on offense. Jalen, it's really, really good on defense. As you can see by the steal, and as you can see that Jordan had the three from behind.
And the three is up, and the three is good. Chris Harding hits the three.
Good movement right there by Chanute. Good ball movement, messing around, finding Chris open, hit him with the three.
Now, I was talking to Jalen and Jordan's dad earlier today, Mr. Duncan, and we were talking exactly what you were talking about. They are brothers, but they are polar opposites. I mean, Jalen, he's only really good at shooting. He's a decent defender, but his size is just, it kind of gets hard for him to defend sometimes. And Jalen is, and there's a foul called on Elliott. And Jalen is a big, bulky, can jump out of the gym. Not a great shooter. He's a good passer, doesn't turn the ball over, and is good at getting to the rim. He's also obviously great at defense.
Two players you want on the same team.
Mm-hmm. Also, we were talking about how most of our players, like, we don't really have a top scorer. Our top scorers go like 10.2 to 10.1, 10, 9.9, just et cetera. Just keeps going down. This whole team plays great all the time. It's not just one guy that keeps us along. Like right now we have Jalen with 2 points, Seamster with 6, Harding with 3, Smith with 4, Jordan Duncan with 3, and Elliott with 3. It's been just a great game all around for every player. And we are up 13 right now.
You watch the Chanute offense, and none of them are selfish. They swing the ball, looking for open.
That was Rocco's first point of the night. Jalen misses that three. And there's a foul called again. And they're going to shoot free throws. I mean, for being that big, he kind of got pushed around down there in the paint. Misses the first free throw. Seamster checking back in for Rhett. Rhett's in a little bit of foul trouble. Don't want to get him to foul out because he is a very effective defensive player.
Chanute having five fouls in the second quarter right now, and we are barely halfway through this.
Rocco knocks down the second free throw. Elliot Stevenson passes it in to Larson. Larson's moving down the court slowly. Plays at his own pace, something we love to see about Larson. Now Elliot looks to make a pass, doesn't. And now we have that mismatch, and it's being exploited. But there is a double team, a reach-in foul called. And that is for Scott's first foul of the second quarter. See, just what we were talking about, exploiting that mismatch right down there in the paint. If they're going to keep putting Dirks on Seamster, then we can exploit that, make a play, have Seamster get to the paint, get easy buckets. Duncan with the ball in the corner. Kind of in a rough spot.
Getting face guarded. They do not want him open.
And there is a foul, a charge called somehow. I think it was a blocking foul, but refs make the final decision. I mean, if you look here, his feet are not set at all. His right foot was in the air. That's a terrible call. And I don't like to bash the refs, but that's just bad. Chanute's back in their man-on-man defense. Seamster isn't even looking at the ball most of the time. He is just looking at Rocco, following him around, not letting him go anywhere. Cal with the ball, doesn't shoot it, gets it to Rocco. Rocco gets around Seamster and puts it in. He has 4 points.
Great play right there by Rocco, going around everybody, finding that open lane, hit the layup.
Chris Harding, and we're looking for something. Try to find Elliott in the paint. There's a foul called. He's gonna stay with Chanute. Find Elliott in the paint. He goes up, misses. Moreland is moving the ball up quick. He takes a little elbow jumper. He was feeling it, but did not knock it down. Larson moving up the court. He's always looking up ahead of him to try to find someone in the paint. Gets the ball to Jordan Duncan in the corner. It is good. Jordan knocks down his second three-pointer of the night. You love to see it.
Fort Scott going on a little run right there, had everything guarded. And then on that last play, Larson cutting in, finding Jordan out on the corner, dishes it to Jordan, easy three.
Find Cal in the corner, he takes one dribble, short corner shot, knocks it down. He has 7 tonight.
Now Cal, he's really shown tonight that you don't want to leave him open.
Mm-mm.
He's knocked down a three. He's been hitting that jumper from mid-range. He's very comfortable with that. I kind of want to see him get warmed up.
There's Jordan wide open again in the corner. What are we doing for Scott? I don't know if you know his name, but that's Jordan Duncan, and he hits threes.
Back to back. He's 3 for 4 tonight.
Uh-huh.
Jordan Duncan's warming up early in this game in the Iowa versus Chanute game. He didn't really hit anything those first three quarters. That fourth quarter came around, and he was a whole different person.
Mm-hmm. For a second there, they had a mismatch where Jordan Duncan was guarding Rocco, but they did not exploit it. Now they have Jordan Duncan guarding Dirks. Student section is getting loud because offense can't do nothing. Larson with the ball in his hands. Throw that alley-oop. Never mind. Ball's in the hands of Jordan Duncan. Elliott moving down the baseline. Tries to make a play, finds Larson. Fakes the swing pass. Jordan gets it to Chris. Chris has the 6'6 Rocco on him. Elliot has it now. 30 seconds left in this first half. 14-point lead for Chanute. Larson with the ball. It looks like we're just going to hold for the last shot unless we get something wide open. Gets the ball to Chris. Elliot moving around. Can't find him. Ball is in Jordan Duncan's hands. He shoots from the logo. Does not knock it down. That was a little bit of a heat check. Three people pull Elliot to the ground, and there is a travel called on Fort Scott's Dirks Kegler. And back in the hands of Chanute, 6 seconds left here. I believe we'll see something drawn up for Jordan Duncan to get a three off the inbound. And if not, get the ball into Seamster or Elliot's hands. Have them go make a play.
Ticket number is 400-425. And the 400-436.
Larson goes to make a play. Lays it up. It's up and good. That'll end this first half with Larson Kester getting on the board. That was a brilliant first half of basketball, Braylon. We'll be back for the second half, and I'm even more excited for the second half. We'll see you then. Don't go anywhere.
Dedicated to high school and college students. Our mission is for every student in Southeast Kansas to know they have value, they are loved, and that they have a place. We are not a church, but we are motivated by the love God has for all of us. The Fire Escape opened in 1998 and is open every Friday and Saturday night for high school and college age students. During the week, the Fire Escape is open to the public Tuesday through Friday mornings for coffee, catch-ups, or small groups like Bible studies. The Fire Escape Coffee House is proud to partner with the Chanute High School Tech classes on this broadcast.
Cut. Beautiful. Okay, let's go again. Anchor!
I got a woman called Claudette Jones.
Tell me about your vision.
At the end of the day, it's your classic coming-of-age story.
Gonna need more shipping labels.
All the gig speed, fiber-fueled internet you need to take whatever and make it big. Sparklight Internet. A stronger connection.
Our attention to the south. Go, Mr. Lincoln, Bill B. will be our first contestant. You have 30 seconds. Well, as soon as we have it, 3, 2, 1, go. For 3! 3, 2, 1, hit it! Ooh! Boom! BG for the free throw.
And welcome back to Chanute, where Chanute is leading 26 points, 29-13.
Bryson. 16 points.
Oh, yeah. Well, it's 13 now. It was 9 going in the half. I guess they just switched it up. But how do you think Fort Scott's going to
They got to start guarding Jordan Duncan. I mean, that's the first thing. They allowed him to get 9 points early, 3-for-4 at the very beginning of this game. And they got to stop turning the ball over. They have 8 turnovers, not something you like to see. Compared to 1, 8-to-1 is not a good ratio when it comes to turnovers for your team. Jordan Duncan with the ball at the top of the key. Rhett Smith sizing up Rocco. Seamster throws it. A little bit of overextension from number 30 there. Seamster shoots the 3. It is off. Rocco gets the board. Can't really out-rebound someone that's 6'6". Dirks with the ball. Throws it off of Duncan's hands. Almost ends up Chanute ball there. Dirks has it, moves it around. Moreland has it now. Finds Dub, who has a really good delayed Euro step there, and then finds Cal, who shoots the mid-range shot. He's been good all night.
We've talked about that mid-range shot. I mean, he's just a bucket from right there. He's comfortable with that jump shot, driving right into the mid-range, right on that shoulder, just throwing it up right there.
Michael Jordan type shot there. He's very good at getting to that spot, too. Ball is knocked away. It'll stay with Chanute. But, yeah, he's very good at getting to his spots and being able to knock him down. Because as a player, if you know you can hit that shot 9 times out of 10, all it takes is you getting there before you get those 2 points on the board. Seamster with the ball. Tries to back down Dirks. Can't do it. Gets down into Rhett. Moves out Jordan Duncan. He's open for 3. What are you doing, buddy? Hey, Cal, step up a little bit now. Jordan Duncan has 12 now.
Chanute moving around the ball and just finding that shot. They always want Jordan Duncan right there.
It's now up to a 17-point lead. Cal with the ball from 3. Misses. Side of the rim. And it is going to – Jordan Duncan accidentally touched that. Kind of got just unfortunate there. It's going to stay here with Fort Scott. Dub has the ball. Looking to find Dirks. Cal – gets to another mid-range spot, doesn't shoot it. And there is Rocco, who knocks down a mid-range. He's up to 6 points now.
Really using that height right there, just shooting over Larson. Really good shot.
Larson looking around, finds Seamster. Larson in the paint. Tries to back down. Gets to the hoop, gets blocked. Gets blocked by Rocco there. Great defensive play. And it is now, and it ended up hitting off of Larson's head. Now it is back in the hands of Fort Scott. There's Dub Chipman. Incredible name. Cal with the ball again. Chipman looking to make a play. Swings it over to number 11. He shoots it. Moreland knocks it down. That is his first points of the night. Oh, that is actually Spencer Goldstone. I'm sorry. He has 3. There's almost a travel, but Chanute is able to keep it. Kind of a wild offense we got here, but Elliott just gets a wide open layup at the rim and 1. Elliott puts it in, and he's heading to the free throw line. Incredible play there.
Elliott finding the lane, laying it up to over 2 defenders right there, making the bucket and being sent to the line. You'd love to see it.
Elliott, I mean, he wears 35 for a reason. Plays like KD. Misses the free throw, though. Ball is being moved around. Spencer gets an open look at the mid-range, doesn't take it. Cal gets an open look mid-range. Not open look, he actually gets blocked. Elliott running up the court. He's a track star for a reason. Lays it up. Elliott was moving up the court very quick.
Jordan got the pass, started looking up, saw Elliott, passed the ball to Elliott. Elliott getting a wide open lane.
There's Dub Chipman with the three. A great pass from Larson to Seamster. Almost gets poked away a couple times. Back the rep, back out to Elliott to reset the offense here. Larson has it, pump fake a couple times, almost lets it fly, ends up getting to the paint and getting fouled. Larson is now heading to the line.
Larson going for the lane, drew the foul. Rocco just standing up there behind him, just puts his hand right there. Mm-hmm. Right there, foul.
Larson at the line. He's normally quite efficient from the line. Knocks down the first. Look at this play here. Larson pump fakes several times and eventually just gets hit on the head while Rocco was going for that block. Larson for the second free throw. Knocks it down as well. They're gonna take a timeout. We're gonna take a timeout with you. We will be back for some more third quarter action.
KFEX 93.1 FM and Comet Vision are excited to partner with Dr. Grant Gastineau. Dr. Gastineau graduated from Chanute High School and is committed to supporting the activities of the youth of Chanute. Thank you, Dr. Gastineau. We appreciate your support.
Hello and welcome back for this third quarter action. So something that I'm been talking about is that Fort Scott has looked a lot better in this second half so far, but Chanute has been able to counteract that and stay hot. We're still up 15, but they've already scored 10 points this quarter.
Fort Scott really giving Chanute a run for their money right now. Coming back,
hit a couple threes.
Will Fort Scott tie this game up before the third quarter ends?
It'll take a heck of a run. Dub Chipman with the ball. Tries to get the ball in to big man. Step back from, almost shot the three. Spencer with the ball, looking to make a move. And Larson comes down with the rebound. And we are pushing it the other way. Seamster with it. Going to just slow it down, get it out to Elliott. Relax for a second. Figure out the offense. Elliott makes play. Step back pretty far. Almost got wide open shot he could have maybe taken. Jordan with the ball. They're guarding him all the way up there at half court now, basically. Don't want him to hit any more shots. Rhett Smith had a wide open opportunity. Does not want to take it. Elliott gets to the bank. Hits Lars in the corner. Larson up, and it is good. Nothing but net. You'll love to see it. He has 7 points now.
Amazing ball movement right there by Chanute, not forcing any shot that they wanted. Finding Larson open in the corner, drains the three.
There is a missed three by Rocco. Don't often see someone that big taking those threes, but if he can knock them down, he can knock them down. Didn't hit that one, though. Rhett with the ball. Hand off to Larson. Larson finds Rhett again. Spencer goes for that steal. Larson hits Seamster. Seamster shoots, does not hit it. Dirks comes down with the board. They're moving the ball up. A minute 38 here. 18-point game. Larson, great help defense, but Rocco just hits it over him. That's where that height really helps out.
Larson not jumping, knowing that if he jumps, he's most likely going to get the foul.
Very smart, disciplined play right there.
Good basketball IQ right there.
Elliott gets fouled. That is Fort Scott's third foul of this half, or of this quarter here. Looks like we have a couple players checking in. No, we just have one. We have Chris Harding checking in for Rhett Smith. Rhett Smith has been kind of an underdog for MVP of this game so far. Beginning, he's the one really got this run on for Chanute. He got those big steals that all led to buckets. Fantastic game from Rhett Smith so far. He hasn't scored the most points, but he's been very impactful. Elliott misses the baby hook. Now Fort Scott moving the ball back up. Less than a minute here. Spencer just steps into that one and absolutely nails it. That was a buttery smooth shot there by Spencer Goldston. He has now hit two threes on the night.
Great pass made to Spencer. Spencer pulling up a little bit behind the arc right there. Amazing shot. Love to see it.
And he just dribbled into it. It was beautiful. 13-point game. They've cut it down quite a bit. Chris is kind of getting locked up. He goes to make a play. Finds Elliott, 24 seconds left. They are guarding very high. Seamster almost gets the ball stolen. 10 seconds left. Need to start moving now. Larson, step back. The three, it is off. Dirks gets it, shoots the basically full court shot. Actually gets fairly close. It is a 13-point game. And we are gonna go into this fourth quarter. I am so excited. We'll be back after this break.
Drugstore, located at 103 East Main in downtown Chanute, is a small-town pharmacy and gift store which includes an old-fashioned soda fountain. They specialize in compounds and vaccines. They also supply many types of medical items. Cardinal Drugstore is your one-stop shop for all of your healthcare needs. KFEX and Comet Vision are so grateful for your support. From kickoff to the final lap, from peewees to the weekend pros, our team of doctors can help with the diagnosis and treatment of sports-related injuries. Wherever you are in your sports journey, Labette Health Sports Medicine team has the training, experience, and skill to repair, restore, and renew. For more information about Southeast Kansas' leading orthopedic and sports medicine program, go to labettehealth.com.
Hello and welcome back. We have one quarter of basketball left. It is a 13-point game. I am excited as ever to see how this game plays out. What are you thinking, Braylon?
We have a good game on our hands right here. Even though Chanute is up by a lot right now, we still got a good game. Fort Scott is still showing that they are a great team and not giving up.
Yeah, Fort Scott scored 13 points in the whole first half and 15 in that third quarter. Dirks makes an athletic play, does not hit the layup. He's going to the line. But something that I would like to point out is that oftentimes this season, Chanute has come out in the third quarter pretty slow, struggling, wasn't able to make plays, make shots, and that's where we ended up losing a lot of our games that we have lost. But this third quarter, we played very efficient. We kept the lead above 10 the whole time. We were up 15 basically the whole quarter. It's something that we love to see, the improvement of these guys, and I think we can make a pretty good run in the playoffs with how good this team has been improving. Elliott with the big-time block on 6'6 Rocco, not letting him get anywhere. Jalen Duncan moving it up. He lays it up with Rocco trailing. Able to make a tough layup there by the freshman. Fantastic. You love to see it. Defense leads the offense. It always has, always will. Spencer almost slips. Finds Cal going back door. Great pass there to get Cal another bucket. He is up to 11 points tonight. They're kind of starting to press here. They need to move the ball up a little quick because they don't have a lot of time left. There could have been an 8-second violation called eventually. You don't want that to happen. Seamster with the ball. Jordan Duncan being guarded very heavily. Tried to find him, wasn't able to. A lot of motion is what will get Jordan Duncan open. Confuse the defense, maybe a possible switch like right here. There's two people guarding Elliott, no one on Jordan Duncan, but they were not able to capitalize on it. And Now that's a turnover for Chanute. Only their second turnover of the night. This might be the best game of basketball we've seen Chanute play all year. up to this point.
Like you were talking about how Chanute gets a little movement going, gets somebody open. Not only does it work on Jordan Duncan, we've seen it a lot. Larson hit a corner three because it made it because of the movement that Chanute's doing right now on offense.
In the corner, the three-pointer is up and missed. Rocco gets the ball. Cal has it. You know he's going to try to make a play. And that is a charge called, and it is going to be Chanute ball. There's another turnover forced. 9 turnovers for Fort Scott so far.
Caden,
incredible play.
Caden putting his body on the line right now, even though they are up 13 right now.
Great play by Caden.
Great play by Caden.
Jalen has the ball. Doesn't turn the ball over often, but there he does. That's a travel called on Jalen. Just got a little sped up, didn't know where the pass needed to go. 13-point game, 6 minutes left. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. This is going to be awesome.
We've seen Chanute make 29 points in one quarter. Could Fort Scott come back from this 13 lead and possibly win this game, Bryson?
Oh, they definitely can. Beautiful step back, but just missed the shot. Larson has the ball, moves it up to Caden Seamster. It's a 3-on-3 little fast break here, but they just slow it down. Don't need to push with the lead. Gets it out to Larson. That almost got a little messed up there, but Larson travels. He wants to call for the push, but does not get it. Now, after I mentioned that they only had one turnover, they've turned it over 3 times since. So something that we don't really want to see. We're going to stay with you through this timeout. Brandon, what have you seen in this fourth quarter that you think can help either team win?
Well, Fort Scott's really coming back right now. Chanute's only leading right now by the 13th lead. Something that's not helping Fort Scott right now is their turnovers. Like you said, Chanute only has 4 turnovers right now. Fort Scott has 9. They're really showing that these turnovers are really affecting them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that both teams can get hot from 3-point range, so you just don't want to see that happen if you're either coach. Because four threes, and we know Cal is able to do that. We know that Kanan Brown is able to do that. We know that Dirks is able to hit threes. We know that Spencer Goldstein is able to hit threes. You just don't want to see any of that happen because they can easily come back very quickly.
But with Chanute right now, Chanute's been playing some lockdown defense.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, all night both teams have played very good defense, not letting a lot of open shots available.
It's just who got the momentum first, and Chanute got the momentum first.
Dirks gets fouled, and he's heading to the line again. Last time went 0 for 2.
Now these free throws right here are big.
This could
give him the momentum that Fort Scott needs to come back.
Free throws are huge. You always need to hit free throws because, I mean, they're called free throws. Free. You need to hit them. They're big in winning games. Honestly, three of the biggest things in winning basketball games is turnovers, free throws, and your defensive presence. He misses both free throws again. Looks like we got Shaq out there or something. Larson bringing the ball up the court. Larson keeping the defender on his back and hitting a tough layup. Incredible play by Larson there. You love to see him do stuff like that.
Larson bringing up the ball full court. Mm-hmm. No passing, no nothing. Just kept that defender on his back right there. Easy lay.
Mm-hmm. Get the ball down, and he just runs over Larson. Don't know where the foul is, but number 30, Chip Dubman, hits another 3. Nobody is in agreement with the no foul call right there. There's a 30-second timeout. We're not gonna leave again. There is 5 minutes left here. We are excited for this. I mean, if you look at this replay,
like, passes the ball out to the corner, runs over Larson right there.
Yeah, I'm not sure why there wasn't a foul called there. I mean, he just straight up ran over Larson. Like, I'm not quite sure why there wasn't a foul called, but it wasn't.
Now, with this timeout that Fort Scott just called, or might have been Chanute, but with this timeout that was just called, this could have just killed the momentum that Fort Scott could have got from that play.
Depending on who called, if Chanute called that timeout, it is an excellent timeout, ending that momentum. Because that you don't want momentum to happen very often. The whole, there's a full court press right now. All five players were on our side of the court. Now Chanute needs to try to get the ball past half court. Chris Harding does a very good job of doing that. Gets the ball to Larson. Larson has a defender all the way up on him. Landon Bilby checked into the game recently. Jordan Duncan there has it. He's, you know, getting face guarded because best three-point shooter in the state of Kansas. Chris tries to make a play. He does. No foul called. He misses the layup. 4 minutes left, 12-point game. This is going to get interesting. Ball's being pushed down the court. Cal has it. Could have shot it. Doesn't want to, though. Dub Chipman doesn't shoot it as well. Now they just reset it. Thought that number 11 was going to take that deep. Bilby gets a hand in there. Great play by Landon. Now Chris is being hard-pressed. Chris moving the ball up the court, keeping the defender on his butt. Now they just reset it to Larson. Not to Larson. Now it's to Chris. Chris moves it to Seamster. Seamster able to get a little bit of an advantage. Hop step goes in and just gets fouled. They called a jump ball. Nobody in the entire world. All right, you ain't got to laugh at him. Come on now. Nobody likes that call.
Right here. Comes in.
He never even touched the ball.
Never, ball was never wrapped up.
That's a terrible call. Awful. Jordan Duncan.
But it is Chanute's ball, so.
But that also loses us a possession for the next possible jump ball. Chris moving. Gets it to. God, they finally call a foul. I mean, I don't know how hard you have to get hit for a foul to be called. Right?
Jordan got hit twice right there. Got called on the second foul.
Mm-hmm. Now they're finally calling stuff. I mean, this fourth quarter has been kind of rough for the refs.
Fort Scott really applying the pressure on defense.
There's another foul call. They're making up for it, I guess. Comet's going to check the ball, pass the ball back in. Gets it to Seamster. He's making a play. He's very high up. Can't really do much. Does a spin move, and he's fouled again. I mean, they're finally calling it, though. That's good, at least. But that's three fouls, one possession. Four.
Fort Scott is not trying to have Chanute waste any time right now.
I don't know if these are intentional or what's really happening. Chris is wide open. He goes to the lane. Pump fakes twice. Gets fouled. And he's going to go to the line because that's their fifth foul of the half. We're already in the bonus. That is huge for Chanute. That means intentional fouls always mean free throws down the rest of this game. So every free throw matters because we're going to end up shooting a lot of free throws tonight in this last 3 minutes, and they have got to be knocked down. Chris Harding misses the first one. And that was Rocco's fourth foul. He is very close to fouling out here. That would be a major loss for Fort Scott.
Rocco's a big player on this Fort Scott team.
Chris
grabbing
misses
the rebound.
Both. See what happens. Spencer wants the ball. Dirk's trying to find him, gets it to him. Spencer Goldman with the ball, trying to make a play on Jordan. And Dirk goes to cut, and the ball is just thrown right out of bounds. That is their 10th turnover of the game. Elliott is checking out for Bilby. Or Elliott is checking in for Bilby, sorry. Now it is. Looks like Rocco is also checking out. So you can see their full court press is one that you do not see often. All five players are pressing all the way up on Chanute. So you would like, so we had Elliott just run out of frame right there because we needed him to make some space for the rest of the players. Chris Harding has it. Now Larson does. Elliott's wide open in the paint. Kind of a pass he had to jump for. Elliott ends up throwing it back out to Seamster. Elliott has it in the corner. Chanute is perfectly fine wasting some time. And there's a foul sending Elliott to the line. You like to keep the ball in Elliott and Larson's hands here and Jordan's hands just so that if they do intentionally foul, we have elite free throw shooters at the line.
But with these free throws, though, come with a lot of pressure because if these free throws are missed, I mean, it just comes with a lot of pressure. Let's see how the boys can hook.
Elliott knocks down the first one.
Let's see how the boys can react under all this pressure.
Now we have Chipman and Rocco both checking back in. Now, if Rocco fouls out, that will be monumental to the outcome of this game. There's another free throw knocked down by Elliott. Goldman with the ball, finds Chipman. Chipman travels, and it is back with Chanute.
This Fort Scott's team moving way too quick for the moment for their own selves. Moving the feet without dribbling.
2 minutes left. 2.5 minutes left. 14-point advantage for Chanute. Very good defense played all night. Elliott has it. Doesn't shoot the three, and there's a foul called on Goldman, and Elliott is going to go back to the line. This is a lot of pressure. You know his heart's beating. It is. But it's got to be huge. We almost actually saw Rocco foul out right there. He almost fouled, but he pulled his hand back, did not end up fouling. Elliott knocks down the first one. It got incredibly quiet in here. Everybody helping Elliott focus.
Can hear a pin drop.
And everyone is on their feet in the student section. Elliott knocks down the second free throw. Talk about an elite free throw shooter. That's Elliott Stevenson.
Especially with all this pressure, if you miss these free throws, it could kill your team's momentum and could start
and Cal
up
Cal shoots a wild, wild shot, but it is rebounded by Rocco, who then gets it to Chipman, who also misses. And Rocco almost gets a steal, but ends up going out of bounds. It's going to stay with Chanute. Here we go. We have all five of Fort Scott's players in the backcourt. Now we're just trying to keep the ball in that man's hands so that he can shoot the free throws because he doesn't crack under pressure. Takes a lot of pressure to make him crack. Call him a diamond. Elliott knocks down the first free throw. I mean, it gets so quiet in here, I can hear the net swish. Elliott for the second free throw to push it to 18. Knocks it down. Free throws are absolutely huge.
Elliott showing that this pressure does not affect him at all.
Then that is a three from Mesopotamia that Goldman just put up. I don't know what he's doing. I would be surprised if he stays in the game because that is an awful shot. I'm marking that down for a turnover because that sucked. Now looking to find Elliott. We get it to Seamster. And there's a foul called on Dirks. I think a timeout's going to be called here. That is a full timeout. We're going to take a break with you. Stay tuned for this last minute, 42 left. We are excited. This will be great. Let's go.
The Medicine Shop Pharmacy, located right across the street from Royster Middle School in downtown Chanute, is in the business of making you feel better, faster. With three licensed pharmacists, the Medicine Shop has the knowledge to know the right drugs and the proper dosage to ensure your safety. If you're not quite up to your game, Medicine Shop offers delivery to your door. The Medicine Shop, a proud underwriter of the Chanute Blue Comets.
Unbelievable! Sparklight is unveiling unlimited internet for just $25 a month. Get reliable 100 meg internet for just $25 a month for 12 months with unlimited data. That's unlimited internet. Call 8.
Hello and welcome back. A minute 42 left, Braylon. We have been able to knock down our free throws, which has put us back up to an 18-point lead here. Chanute has a lot to prove with this game, and we have played very efficiently. I think it's been our best game all around all year. Holding Fort Scott to 33 points is absolutely incredible. First free throw is missed. Here we can see the last turnover that was made by, you can see number five is like, what are you doing, buddy? Now, nope, missed both of those free throws. Elliott ready to play, and there's a foul called on Seamster, just trying to get a steal. It's fine, we have fouls to give. Minute 32 left, that's only a second. We're all right with that. 18-point game. The three-pointer's gonna have to be huge, but you don't need to shoot them from outer space. That's all I'm saying. Ball's almost stolen a couple times there. Goldman has the, no, that's not Goldman, that is Cal with the ball. He gets it, ends up almost wide open. Dirk's in the corner, shoots the three, in and out, and then that is just taken by Rocco. That is his 11th point tonight.
Cal spin moving around the two defenders, found the open lane, dished out to Dirk. Dirk misses the three-point, and there's Rocco putting the ball back up.
There's Elliott with it, and then a foul is eventually called on Dirk there, I believe, and this is going to send Seamster back to the line. Let's hope we can knock down these. Less than a minute left. Seamster knocks down the first. Love to see it. That's his 7th point of the night. All right, Caden, let's make it 8. Caden puts it up, knocks it down. 8, back to an back to an 18-point lead.
Fort's got not trying to waste any time.
No, they're not. Cal with the ball, shoots another NBA range 3. Nothing but backboard, love to see it. Seems to running down the court. I think he might dunk it. He tries, and there's a foul called. That would have been insane, but he does end up at the line nonetheless.
He wanted it.
That would have been awesome. That would have ended up on ESPN tomorrow, I'll tell you that much. Seamster misses the first.
As you see, he was right there.
Knocks down the second. Seamster now with 9 points. A little bit of pressure to make him pick up the ball. Goldman running down in the corner. Finds. And there's 30 seconds left, 19-point lead. They're not even gonna foul. Chanute wins this huge game against Fort Scott. This is monumental towards the playoff seeding and playoff bracket. You love to see it. Chanute takes down the foe that beat them once behind a great team effort, but a lot from Elliott, 13 from Elliott. Larson got his, Jordan had 12. Amazing game. We will see you guys at the next home game. And if that wasn't an exciting game, I don't know what was. Chanute played incredible defense, incredible offense, and that led to the win. So
it's hard to pick somebody from the Chanute team that played awesome tonight when you have the score sheet, the pass and the ball. Everybody's moving around. Everybody's playing like a team. It's amazing when you see a team like this play on the court.
And that'll do it for tonight's stream. I hope you guys had a wonderful time watching, and we'll see you guys at the next home game.